In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to use the material presets tool to quickly create and assign flare materials to objects or components in the scene, and to save your own material attributes in a preset for future use. I'm Henriette from Arteneering, and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's preset some materials. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to select and work with globals to modify effects individually over the entire image. Now it is time to enter the material realm and customize how each object in the scene will look like. While Flair can work with normal Maya materials, if the Mix Maya Materials global is enabled, these will be limited in terms of art direction and features. So let's learn how to make the most out of Flair materials. Similarly to working with shader style presets, let's begin with the Material Presets tool. The Material Presets can be opened by clicking on the Pres icon in the Flair shelf and is divided in two sections, the Saving section at the top and the Loading section at the bottom. You might already be familiar with presets in Flair if you watched the Style Presets tutorial. Material presets work in the same way, each preset containing a collection of different attributes that define the Flair material. Maya's Hypershade can also be used to create, assign, and modify Flair materials, but working with the Material Presets tool can significantly speed up your workflow. You can simply select any objects you want to work with, choose a preset, and either double-click on it or press the Load button. This will automatically create a Flair material if one was not previously assigned and set the values contained within the preset onto it. It is super easy to assign and change material values this way. Flair materials can also be assigned to components, so you can select the faces that you want to apply a preset on and load it. Ha! That does not look right, but it's exactly what should happen. The Material Presets tool will always try to change the material first. In this case, the material assigned to these faces is also assigned to all the other objects. So it will change the material assigned to all objects. To change this behavior, make sure that Create New Material option is toggled so that the tool will create a new material along with a preset instead of just changing the material already assigned to it. Makes sense, right? Once objects or components have a different material, you can disable Create New Material and change material presets using the normal tool behavior. The remaining loading options allow you to choose if you want to also load the preset textures, the noise effects, and all other attributes. These are useful if you want to keep your textures but load all other values, or to load only the textures or noise effects or any other preset onto the assigned material. If you like these options when working with presets, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this. Back to presetting. If you have a lot of material presets, make sure to take advantage of filtering, which only shows presets that contain whatever you write in their name. For example, let's quickly filter skin presets and apply one of them to this object. The combo box next to filtering by text allows to filter materials by style, as there are some materials that only work with a cutout or hatching style. You will rarely need to change this, as it should automatically change when you're working in the respective styles. There are also presets with custom behaviors to take note of. The underscore inherit preset will automatically create a new material and try to inherit the attributes of whatever material has been previously assigned, be it a Flair material or a Maya material. This is useful to duplicate and separate an existing Flair material on selected objects or components, or to selectively convert other materials to Flair materials. The underscore proxy preset will create an invisible material that can only be used to art direct effects. We cover these type of materials later in a separate tutorial. Presets with the underscore textured suffix will automatically prompt to assign an albedo texture to the material upon loading. This speeds up creating textured materials and allows you to also create your custom textured presets by appending underscore textured to the preset name. Talking about saving presets, just select the object or components containing the material that you wish to save as a preset, enter the new preset name and press Enter or click on Save. Keep in mind that if the new preset has the same name as an existing preset, the old preset will be overwritten by the new one. Also, if more materials are assigned to your selection, a small prompt will appear, showing the assigned materials and asking you which one you'd like to save a preset from. Like the style presets, each preset can be edited or renamed. This is done by right-clicking on them. Edit preset will open up the default text editor with the contents of the preset. Presets are plain JSON files containing Flair global attribute names and their values. Renaming presets will open a small rename dialog to quickly change the name. If you don't like some presets, you can delete them too. Just select the booger and click on delete. A confirmation dialog will appear, as deleting a preset cannot be undone. Click on yes to eradicate it, or no in case you decide to give it a second chance. From loading presets with all their different options and behaviors to the special presets that provide additional functionality to saving presets and organizing them. There's a surprising depth to working with material presets, but now you know everything there is to it. That is, until we come up with new things. Be sure to check out the documentation then, linked in the description below, as everything there will always be up to date. With material presets covered, it is time for us to go down the rabbit hole for individual attributes within Flair materials to completely customize their behavior and break all the rules of physics if artistically needed. If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Thanks for watching, and let's customize Flair materials in the next one.